storms are increasing. But in some cities, sewer infrastructure has aged out and can't redirect the water to keep up with rapid urbanization. This creates frequent flooding in many downstream neighborhoods. But could this create the solution to California's water shortage?
It's a smart water system. I hate that term, but that's kind of what we're trying to build. So a city like LA might flush 1 billion gallons into the Pacific after a large rain event because the infrastructure was designed to do that. It was designed to get the water out of the city as fast as you could. You can strategically hold back certain portions of that water and potentially even reuse it. You're effectively talking about solving LA's water problem.
Using sensors that will connect to the internet, this smart water system could control the valves and pumps needed to divert water into neighborhoods unaffected by the storm.
We have these new advanced technologies in the form of microcontrollers and wireless communications. We're trying to take that and attach it to infrastructure to make it more dynamic, to make it more adaptive, and to make it more responsive.
Right now we're assembling some of these sensor nodes. We're gonna have 10 distributed within a 3-square-mile catchment.
There you go.
We are on our way to what's called Ellsworth Pond. We identified it because we got access to it from the county.
You'll see, it takes like a day or two to deploy this. And then all of a sudden you have data that you've never seen before, like streaming at like a minute resolution, right?
Do we have the wrench?
They're gonna measure the flow in open channels, they're gonna measure soil moisture, they're gonna measure rainfall, and they're also gonna measure water quality. And as soon as you connect the battery, the data starts streaming to the internet, and you can visualize it, or more importantly, you can start feeding it to larger scale models that we're running to predict how flows are gonna behave down the road. We're not offering a new solution, we're just taking what exists and attaching these technologies to them to make them more effective. You can do that, it turns out, for way less money. And hopefully the lessons that we learn at the 3-square-mile area are going to help inform how we build the cities of the future and how we manage water in large urban environments. We're prototyping a platform for the measurement of hypoxic conditions on smaller and medium-sized lakes.
So we put the boat out on the water. It's going to use this temperature sensor to measure where there's variations in temperature throughout.